This is an original 8-sheet circus poster from 1938 for Ringling Brothers and Barnum and Bailey, featuring Terrell Jacobs, the Lion King. This poster was in horrible condition, the biggest job, and in my 33 years of restoring vintage posters, this was the most challenging yet. Take a look. As you can see, we are using solvents to slowly remove the old canvas from this poster. This poster was hanging by grommets and rope in someone's house over the last 70 years. Because it was exposed to the air and because of the pulling action of the rope, the poster frayed off the canvas, breaking along the fold lines. The poster was ripped along all the fold lines, leaving it in pieces but still attached to this old canvas. Now we are using solvent to remove this old canvas. Now that the canvas has been removed, it is evident that the poster is in pieces, sections where it broke along the folds. But there is a lot of old glue residue on the paper. This was not an archival linen backing. This previous backing was done with resin glues, and the resins are all seeped into the paper and need to be cleaned off as much as we can. Days of exposure to solvents for me.
This is day number 3 of taking this poster off its original backing.
It is now day 5 of cleaning the glue residue off the pieces of the poster. And the pieces seem to be clean now. While the paper airs out, we will prepare this big screen for stretching the canvas. This is an oversized screen, the biggest screen we have in the shop.
Good job.
Now we're going to do a preliminary organization of the pieces on the screen to see how it all comes together, to make sure it fits, and to see where everything should go so that we can glue it down. Once it's glued down, it's down for good.
So we have these pieces missing. We're going to recreate. You what?
I don't know how those pieces are supposed to meet.
Yeah, maybe I better pull out more of the small pieces.
Or
What do you mean the middle?
The middle row.
Really?
Yeah, because then we can literally just align the rest accordingly. And that's gonna be the way to literally match it up.
Now that we know we have room, right? It's not so tight now, right?
It's not.
So that's good. So yeah, well, you have the option now of doing anything. You have flexibility, right?
So, how much room do you need for a rest?
Well, I'd like a lot.
Right. Yeah, then I mean, it's useless marking it now, but it's good to have some kind of measurement.
This left-hand corner area is completely missing. We're going to have to recreate it later.
Gives us room all around.
We need room because we have to recreate some of the margins, the white margin.
I still got these pieces, some of them, but we're going to put the big stuff down. So it fits pretty well. Hard to get the whole thing in the frame though, because it's so big. Gives us a comfortable amount of space.
Day 8. After doing some extra cleaning to the paper, we're finally ready to put it down onto a linen backing, piece by piece. I'm now mixing the wheat paste. It is similar to the stuff that they use for wallpaper, but this is a finer grade, and I add an acid neutralizing agent to it. I've also added another type of glue, which is compatible, and which will strengthen it in the event that any of the old residue repels the wheat paste. There's bound to be areas of the paper that do not want to absorb my wheat paste because of the old residues in the paper, which I spent 5 days removing, but cannot guarantee they're 100% gone. Using a roller, I'm applying the wheat paste to the acid-free paper. I have to spread it out evenly so that there are no dry spots, which is critical in getting a good result. As you can see, I am putting the wheat paste onto the acid-free paper, which will be mounted to the canvas.
Putting the first sheet of paper down.
It takes 2 sheets of the acid-free paper to fill this size screen, which is over 125 inches wide by 100 inches tall. We are now ready to permanently assemble the poster.
I think we should maybe match the blue line up to the pencil line, the blue line, because that's the straightest line.
Right.
And we can always guide it that way.
Ringling Brothers and Barnum & Bailey Circus. This lithographic poster was printed by Strobridge in 1939. Surrounded by several ferocious lions, tigers, panthers, and leopards, on this vintage circus poster is Terrell Jacobs, a famous jungle cat trainer who performed with Ringling Brothers and Barnum & Bailey in 1938 and 1939 in a career spanning 40 years. Jacobs was a well-established entertainer who worked for 16 different circuses and even owned his very own.
Hey, it's kind of easy to wipe off, and I think it's kind of like the glue that's the old residue of the old glue is kind of repelling.
Yeah.
I hope it sticks. Does it feel like it's absorbing?
I mean, it doesn't feel bad.
Yeah, it looks like it's sticking okay.
It has become distinctively clear to me that I'm going to have to put this camera down and lend a hand, so we will rejoin this project in a few days after the poster's dry and we have begun the restoration. No, sorry. That's right. I'm going to help you. Oki is using acid-free newsprint to create a big paper fill to put into this missing corner. Day 9. And now Oki will lift up the wet paper which has been drenched with methyl cellulose glue without ripping it. Terrell Jacobs was born in Indiana on September 16, 1903, to Mary Jane and Charles M. Jacobs. Jacobs was known as the Lion King. He was one of the greatest American wild animal trainers. In his 40-year career, Terrell Jacobs was featured on 16 different circuses and carnivals, and also owned his own circus. In 1938 and 39, while working with the Ringling brothers Barnum and Bailey Circus, Terrell performed with the largest number of lions, tigers, and leopards that had ever been assembled in one area. As you see in this poster, the act was advertised as having 50 wild animals. The number was more like 30 to 35. However, this is still a very impressive number. In 1940, Jacobs purchased an 8-acre farm in Peru, Indiana, to serve as his winter quarters. He then built barns to house his large collection of circus animals. The structures still stand today, or at least some of them do, and have been recognized by the state of Indiana for their historical value. But more on that later. After leaving the Ringling Show, Terrell Jacobs started an animal show which he exhibited at fairs and large carnivals. Bill Woodcock presented the elephants on the show and trained a new elephant handler, Fred Logan, who went on to become a great elephant presenter in his own right.
Thank you.
Hello, Poster Fix, may I help you?
What happened here?
What?
The pieces disappeared.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, my God. Maybe it stuck to the paper where I was ironing. That must have been what happened. That's what I'm thinking, because I just ironed there a minute ago.
I think that a lot of too much naphtha is absorbed with the oil and then doesn't stick. Mm-hmm.
We're finding various areas of the poster that lift up because the glue is resisting sticking.
I think more dry is going to come more out.
In 1944, Jacobs took out his own truck show, the Terrell Jacobs Wild Animal Circus. The show, however, was short-lived. In 1945, Jacobs was divorced from his wife, Dolly, and forced to sell the circus. The show was sold to Arthur Wirtz, who used the equipment to form the Barnes Brothers Circus. Jacobs remained with the show, working the animal act. After Barnes, Terrell worked for Ben Davenport on the Austin Brothers Circus, which was the smaller unit of Davenport's Daly Brothers Circus. Jacobs' career spanned over 40 years. At one time or the other, he had worked for almost every major circus in the country. Algy Barnes, Sells Floto, Christie Brothers, Lee Brothers, Robbins Brothers, John Robinson, Gentry Brothers, Howe's Great London, Gilbert Brothers, Holland Classical Circus, Arthur Brothers, Barnes Brothers, Algy Kelly Miller Brothers, and many large railroad carnivals, and he was featured at the 1940 San Francisco World's Fair. Terrell Jacobs died on December 24, 1958 at his home in 12 Mile, Indiana. The artist of this poster is anonymous. However, a word or two about the printer who created this poster. The Strobridge Lithographing Company. While Strobridge Litho was incorporated in 1867, the company traced its origins to 1847 with the establishment of an engraving firm by Elijah Middleton of Cincinnati. In 1854, Heinz Strobridge, a local bookseller, joined the firm as a partner. After the Civil War, Strobridge bought out the other partners and named the company after himself. Beginning in the 1880s, as the Strobridge firm specialized in poster printing, it established offices in New York and London with a representative in Sydney. In 1887, a disastrous fire destroyed the company's factory, but Strobridge immediately rebuilt and increased its national and international presence. As an 1896 advertisement clearly stated, quote, "You see Strobridge posters all over the world." The last circus poster printed by Strobridge firm was in 1954 for the Ringling show. In 1960, the Strobridge company was purchased by the H.S. Crocker Company of San Bruno, California. Even today, after more than a century, the circus posters designed and printed by the Strobridge Litho Company continue to resonate because of their artistry and lively design. From the 1880s through the 1910s, Strobridge had the finest craftsmanship for the creation of lithography in the United States, rivaled only by Donaldson Litho.
Poster Fix paper pulp. It's a mixture of paper powder with methyl cellulose. I filled in the areas of missing paper with that, and now I'm going in with water reversible gouache to retouch the areas that have this paper fill. I can get a better spread when I add bits of water to the paint. The water acts as a medium that thins out the paint. However, if I get it too thin, I don't get a good solid pigment, forcing me to go in and doing a second coat. However, that can also create a nice effect of flatness. Then going in with a hairdryer also helps to dry each layer quickly so that we can go in and do another layer if necessary.
Well, we've just stood the poster up, so now we're going to work on it in a standing position.
Okay, you see this empty corner where there's no image? We are going to create an image, or I should say, Oki is going to recreate it. She's a master. Not sure if I'll be able to photograph her because I'll be too busy helping her. Thank you.
Either have a public hearing or you come out with a document that says, this is what we've got. Do you believe what that general strategy is on behalf of
Speaker Pelosi's tactic with this? You know, they jerk on people, but the narrative was already out. Speaker Pelosi does this time and time again. We should have released the full transcript of the voter testimony. Why won't they release that to the public? Ranking members of Congress cannot even go in and read that testimony. Republican or Democrat can't even find out what happened in those meetings that they're going to try to use to impeach a president of the United States. That's the star chamber that Nancy Pelosi is
running now. Jackie Spears, Democrat from California, she's at all eyes around the world and thrilling our adversaries. I don't know what else she had to say, but is there a crime to be found in there?
Yes or no? No. I mean, Rudy Giuliani is doing his own thing. The president runs the foreign policy of this country. And that's been very clear. In the meeting yesterday, by the way, we had the Secretary of Defense, we had the Chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff. The author of the articles of impeachment, a Democrat himself, said, if they think President Trump is in and let them impeach him, they think that's their only way. Trump's agenda is all that matters in the whole world, but the speaker's sloppy execution, well, that leaves a lot to be desired. Today, we saw this all play out in real time. Pelosi and her colleagues were attending a meeting surrounding the administration's policy in Syria. Well, let's say a picture, well, speaks a thousand words on Twitter. Well, the president called this nervous, nasty, unhinged meltdown. Just like you feel very same time, that photo was taken. The House voted for a measure spearheaded by Pelosi, rebuking the president's withdrawal of American troops from Syria. Some Republicans even supported the measure. It would leave lawmakers needing to keep in mind. President Trump, well, he promised to beat the living out of the so-called ISIS caliphate, not so-called, there was a caliphate. He removed Obama's insane, ridiculous Democrat.
Do you need any other pictures? Bigger picture?
What?
Do you need a bigger picture?
The wild animal trainer. For 100 years, it was arguably the star attraction at any circus. Cajoling, forcing, bullying the world's most dangerous animals to perform stunts that took the audience's breath away, and arguably the world's most famous animal trainer, hailed from Peru, Indiana, was Terrell Jacobs.
He was an amazing trainer,
says circus historian Bruce Embry.
He put lions and tigers in the same cage at times, which is a rough thing to do. They don't get along well.
Terrell Jacobs, the Lion King, he was called. The greatest wild animal trainer of all time. Jacobs worked for Ringling Brothers and all the big circuses. He had his own circus in Peru for a time, performing now legendary feats like stuffing 40 lions, leopards, and tigers into one cage. And when the snow fell and circus season ended for the year, Jacobs returned to Peru to his 8-acre plot just off Highway 31.
Yeah.
Abandoned now for 30 years, in one of these barns was a performance ring in the center, surrounded by cages for the big cats. Here, Jacobs worked his animals daily, keeping them in shape for next season's tour. For decades, circus and history buffs tried to buy Terrell Jacobs' winter quarters and restore it, never successful. Embry says,
oh, it's in horrible shape. It's just sat there and fell into ruin, and it's a shame. We lose some history.
Embry says numerous attempts to save Jacobs' winter quarters have been made, but one argument always defeated the effort. Once the property is restored, what to do with it?
There just aren't enough circus buffs who'd want to pay money for a tour, no matter how historic it might be.
Embry says history, just as history, doesn't have much meaning if history doesn't add something. If it's not something more than a building you drive by, it doesn't really serve a purpose anymore. So Indiana bulldozers have knocked it down. Another page torn from Indiana's history book, a book growing slimmer every day. A lot of great things get destroyed when they're not used. Thankfully, Terrell Jacobs' memory survives in posters and in historical records. Thank you.
If you have any questions about the restoration of your vintage posters, give me a call or send me an email. I'd be happy to talk to you.
Day 22.
We're going to finish up these letters so that they look as good as these letters do that my wife did.
Our embassy, the reason was we were an embassy in a foreign capital, right? Because everybody told us, I mean, we were lectured by guys saying, you're not going to have any access, you're going to have to play the game to get access.
Thank you.
We have cut this gigantic poster off the screen, and now it's lying flat on the table.
At the customer's request and against my recommendation, I am installing grommets so that this poster can be hung the way it was hung before. It would probably be far better to frame it under UV plexiglass if such a glass could be cut this size.
Two sides done, two more to go. Thank you. we have completed putting the grommets on this poster.
This brings us to the end of the restoration and linen backing of this vintage poster of Terrell Jacobs. Thanks for watching.